Hey, what's up guys, Ayush here from Explore Gadgets. So yesterday Nvidia formally announced the next generation GeForce GTX 1080 and GeForce GTX 1070 GPUs ahead of its competitor AMD. With these two graphic cards, Nvidia gave us a taste of its title consumer GPUs based on their new Pascal architecture. So here are the 5 things you should know about their new GPU series. The first up is performance. Nvidia's founder and CEO Jensen Huang jokingly described the two GPUs as having irresponsible amount of performance, promising that the GTX 1080 is twice as powerful and thrice as power efficient as the previous flagship GeForce GTX Titan X, and is way faster than two GeForce GTX 980 cards in an SLI. The GTX 1070 is also faster than the Titan X, though the exact number were not presented. The GTX 1080 can push out 9 teraflops of single precision graphic computing power and can be overclocked to more than 2 GHz. It has 8 GB of VRAM, which is incidentally Micron's new faster GDDR5X RAM running at 10 GB for a total bandwidth of 320 gigabits per second. The GTX 1070 is rated for 6.5 teraflops and also has 8 GB of VRAM, but of the ordinary GDDR5 variety, which is 7 GB, both supports a resolution of 7680 by 4320 at 60Hz. Pretty darn incredible. Though further details of the GTX 1070 are not available yet, but it will share several capabilities with its bigger sibling, including support for DirectX 12.1, OpenGL 4.5, Vulkan, and Nvidia's own G-Sync game stream and GPU boost. Now next up is power requirement and temperature efficiency. Power requirement of GTX 1080 is pegged at 180 watt, and Nvidia lists a 500 watt power supply as adequate for a PC with a single one of these cards, which is incredibly low for the performance per watt. And more intriguingly, demos on stage indicated that it can run comfortably at 2.1 GHz on air cooling without getting hotter than 67 degrees. Huang indicated that this is the highest speed that any previous GPU has ever achieved with even liquid cooling. And on the bright side, third-party graphic card vendors will likely ship dramatically overclocked versions of both GPUs using custom coolers. This news is perhaps a paradise for hardcore gamers. Now, next on our list is the price. When a graphics card is promised to have giant leaps of performance and power efficiency, the expected price is likely to be high. But on the contrary, Nvidia announced some astounding numbers that aroused a great deal of interest from gamers everywhere. Graphic cards based on GTX 1080 will be available at a starting price of only $599, while GTX 1070 cards will go for just $379. There will also be a Founders Edition of both cards, promising extreme overclocking for $699 and $449 respectively. With better performance than Titan X and half its price, you simply don't need to think twice before getting your hands on these cards. Now next up is the brand new Pascal architecture. Now named after the 17th century French mathematician Pascal, this next gen family of GPUs succeeded over the Maxwell architecture and boasted some exceptional improvement over it. With billions of dollars spent in R&D budget and thousands of people working on the GPU project for more than 2 years, Pascal is set to offer up to 10 times performance over the Maxwell architecture in extremely rough estimates. While it is the first desktop chip to use TSMC's 16 nanometer thin-field effect transistor, but the most significant feature of this architecture is the NVLink, which is a new standard for interconnecting between GPUs and CPUs that would complement the current PCI Express bus. Now, this in simple terms means faster data transfer for better gaming performance and better graphics, allowing up to 80 gigs per second compared to the 16 gigs per second available now. The other great innovation with this architecture is the stacked memory, which allows to build more compact GPUs, and unified memory, which will enable applications that take advantage of what GPUs and CPUs can do quicker and easier by allowing the CPU to access the GPU memory. Though I can go on and on about this billion-dollar GPU architecture, I will leave some links in the description down below if you want to go more into the technical details. Now, last on the list is simultaneous multi-projection for independent viewports, which is perhaps an inherent feature with the Pascal architecture. Now, this feature allows users to use multiple flat monitors simultaneously, but instead of having one large frame on a single frame chopped into pieces, each monitor can receive its own feed with the viewport and perspective adjusted to the angle relative to the other monitors. Users who have three monitor setup will no longer have to keep all three flat in one plane or deal with perspective distortion. Now, this used to require three independent graphic cards, but can now be achieved with a single GTX 1080, which can output three different projections in a single pass. One of the honorable mentions of the keynote is Nvidia Ansel. Nvidia's Ansel is world's first in-game 3D camera system dedicated for those who enjoy incredible production value and artwork of recent games. This allows gamers to independently adjust camera positioning and angles to capture scenes within open game worlds. A user can capture frames which are otherwise not easily composed. Images are exported at way higher resolution than the output to the monitor, and with one click, users can export images which can be experienced with any head-mounted display like an HTC Vive or an Android phone using Google Cardboard. A few titles which will support Ansels are The Division, The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt, and No Man's Sky. Now, recording gaming contents has certainly been taken to the next level with the advent of Nvidia Ansel. Nvidia seems to be taking the PC gaming to the next level with its pixel-crunching Pascal GPU architecture. And with the advent of GTX 1000 series, it won't be an understatement to say Nvidia has justified gaming perfected. And for those of you excited to get your hands on one of these, GTX 1080 will be available on the 27th of May, while the GTX 1070 will be available on the 10th of June. So that's all for this video, guys. I hope you found this video interesting. Now do let me know in the comment section about what you think about these new GPUs. Stay subscribed for more. Thank you guys for watching, and you guys have a great day.